I'm inside the car and I would like to talk why I want to update my current stereo system in the car. So before I had the Legacy 2009 with Harman Kardon system in that, and it was beautiful. The sound played very good and I really enjoyed it. So now it was the time to change my car to something newer, and this one is Legacy 2013, as I said before. So in this car I have 6 speakers. Sometimes you can get the car with 4 only speakers and you have only one speaker on every door. Me, I have here on left and on the right 2 extra speakers. They called tweeters and they serve to play high frequency. In my case, my door speakers, they are full range speakers, and it's very important to understand. So when you put your ear next to your speaker at the door and you put some music on it, you should hear the music normally playing like it should. And in case of my Harman Kardon system, when I put my ear next to that speaker on the front doors, the sound was kind of muffled, but because it was middle range speakers, they play only middle, they don't play any bass, and they didn't play any high tone frequency from the music. So pay attention to that when you're buying speakers, because people are complaining after. Or, you know, I bought those speakers, it turned to be out that sound is worse than it was before. Because when you buy middle range speakers, you should add subwoofer to your system, which I am about to do as well. So I already listened my here indoor speakers, and I can tell you they play the full range, and it's bass, middle and high. Also those two on the top plays high as well. On the back it's also full range speakers. So let's this one is called head unit. I believe it provides 50 watts per channel, per 4 channels. Pretty loud, and I like it how it sounds. And here I have that setting, that control when you can change bass, you can change middle, and you can change treble. If you have only 4 speakers in your car, that thing will not exist in your car, I bet. Because I have those tweeters at the left and right, that's why I have treble here. Basically that's it, and I can tell you what now it sounds kind of good, but I would like to try something else, and I hope it will play better than current setup. So this is it for now, and next I will discuss, I will show you my speakers I bought and with subwoofer, etc. Okay. So guys, now I would like to show you the gear I bought, and so let's talk what you could consider to buy. So these speakers, you can see it says here coaxial two-way speaker system. This is the size of speakers, actually it's a diameter, and this one you should consider when you buy, because it should fit exactly what you have in your car. I'll put the link in the description so you will see when you can check what your car have currently as speaker size, and so it will give you an idea what you need to buy. Also, you need to consider important thing, impedance, and it says 4 ohms, because normally you will buy speakers what will match your head unit impedance. So it could be 2 ohms, 4 ohms, 8 ohms, etc. And if it will not match, you can fry your head unit or amplifier, or it will play not as supposed to. So this one, it's, you should don't pay attention to peak power. It's kind of doesn't mean anything, actually is a good one. This one is important thing, RMS power, and that one is 80 watts. So let's talk about what's that coaxial. And what is not coaxial? Because that, you see, it says component two-way speakers. And the difference is, you can see here. So, let's get back to coaxial. It's coaxial because you have tether here, and it's on the same axle as a woofer, that one. And this one, big one, it's a mid-range speaker, and that one is high-frequency speaker, tweeter, okay? So, getting back to this one, it also says 80 watts RMS power, the same size, and here we can check, it says impedance for ohms, actually 3.7, diameter, mounting depth, it's also important. And on that link what I will provide, it's a Pioneer website. It has a good database of cars with their speakers, because depth is also important, because sometimes could be very shallow, sometimes could be deep. So, that one comes with split tweeter, as you can see here. So that one plays again only mid-range, that one plays only high frequencies. And important thing here, it comes with crossover. What's that? It's a filter. And how you plug it, actually the speaker input goes here, and the sound goes on this speaker, plus you attach that thing, crossover, and that will filter only high frequencies to that speaker, tweeter. As you can see, there is one filter as well, so it will remove all bass. That's why that speaker will play only mid-range. And that speaker, coaxial, has as well a couple of filters here. You can see this and this, to filter out low frequencies bass, and also probably, I believe, high frequencies will go only to this one. Important thing to consider, you cannot plug this tweeter without using this, because it's not supposed to play any frequencies except high tones. And if you plug it directly like that to speaker input, you will fry it. Actually, what happened with mine, I received it like that. One tweeter was already blown. So, I have another tweeter, for example. And as you can see, there is a filter one here, capacitor. And I plugged it directly to my home amplifier receiver for TV. And it worked perfectly, because that filter was cutting out all frequencies except high tones. So, for example, if you decide to check impedance, it's very easy. So, you need to have the multimeter. Where is ohm section resistance? So, I will put it to 200 here, because I know it should have, that speaker should have something around 4 ohms. So you take this and do that. Normally it should show you something around 4. My case is showing 4.5, 0.6. So that's alright. It shouldn't show you 8, or it shouldn't show you 2. Let's check this one. So, it show you 4.7, 0.8. And also we can check the tweeter. I don't know, that one maybe fried, maybe not. I don't remember actually. So, if it's fried, it will show 1. It's like infinite. See? This one tweeter is fried. It should show you the resistance, but there is nothing there. So, next, since, also when you buy speakers, often they come with a ring bracket,
So it will help you to attach it to your door. It has different holes here so you can spin and screw it properly in your door mounting hole. Okay, so as I said before, these two speakers. So this I plan to put on my rear door, so it will have, supposedly it will have good high tones and good middle. This one, since I have, as I said before, I have tweeters on my dashboard, so I will put that on my door, front doors, and tweeters supposed to go on my dashboard. That's why I bought component plus coaxial speakers. And I bought as well that subwoofer because my speakers will play only mid-range frequencies and high frequencies. But they don't play, already tested on my home amplifier. It doesn't play any bass at all. Well, you can say it plays mid bass, but it's very low level of bass, so it doesn't do much of volume. So I will need to install this one. It says 10-inch powered subwoofer. Powered subwoofer means it has an amplifier built in, and I will show you shortly. So here max doesn't mean anything. This 125 watts RMS. And since it has built-in amplifier, you will need to buy a kit. I already ordered it, and I will show you later that kit to because you need to bring the power to this thing. And your power usually take from the battery. So in that kit you will have fuse, cable for that power, and some extra stuff, and I will show you later. So here you can see you connect battery power, you connect remote power turn on, you connect ground. Two important things: that subwoofer supports high input from speakers. It means what you take the signal, let's say you have rear speakers somewhere in the trunk, so you can take that signal directly from the speakers. You have plus minus for the left, you have plus minus for the right speaker. Or if your head unit has a RCA outputs, usually it's the low level signal, not amplified one, and you plug it here. It has sub gain, you can control that. How much power will produce your. Actually, it's that level of amplifying. You have a remote here, and that remote you can. You will need actually to route next to you somewhere, so you can control the volume of the bass. And that one, it's a filter when you choose to reproduce frequencies, let's say from 50 hertz to, let's say, somewhere up to here, it will play from that to here, that bass. And you have phase and the fuse. But before you install anything, experts says you need to think about of sound deadening, and I will show you. I already ordered some stuff here that I bought on Amazon. That pack cost $100. You have 47 sheets like that. It's that the pack is kind of heavy, and I will show you what it does. It's self-adhesive and it kills all vibrations you can have, plus killing vibrations, it will kill as well some noise what you can have. So check this out. This is a metal sheet. Basically, the car is made from the same metal. Check this out. You see? And now, look at this. Do you see the difference? This is it. I can show you again. You see? So, experts say what? Applying that thing on your car, you will improve significantly stereo system and output from your speakers, because speakers will lose a lot of energy on vibration. So when sound goes from the speaker, it will go hit from the back to the door, plus it will go and hit something else, and the energy will spend on the vibrations. So, and I also will show you, you will need to apply that thing inside of the door, plus you can apply that thing on the in the trunk to improve the bass output. Plus, I ordered that thing because that kills vibrations and some noise, but that will cover entirely. It's a heat resistance plus noise reduction. It's kind of 8 millimeter thick. It's self-adhesive as well, and it has some foil on the top, and it doesn't burn. So if you will try to burn it, it's not supposed to be burned. So we can try to have a demonstration here. I want to try this sound deadened material. That roll, it's 1 square meter, and it costs around 20 bucks. So I will try to play music on this speaker and try to at the same time cover it. So let's see if it works. So my cameraman will put some music and we will see. Say it really works, but not like 100% cutting out the whole sound, but okay, put on the post. Basically, that's it for this video. I will do that the review on this wonderful speaker as well, so stay tuned. And as well, in next video, I will show you how I will try to soundproof my car. And after, I will install a subwoofer. So, thanks you for watching, and please press on like button. Thank you.